Hey guys, welcome back to Freedom Fighters. Well, this is it, the last chapter, the last big battle. We came a long way, filled with hardship, sorrow, betrayal, and a new hope. But now, it's time to end this.
This is it, fellas. Governor's Island. The baddest boys in red are holed up in here, waiting for backup. We ain't alone either. I've got guys hollering at me from all around the states telling me that everyone's planning a major blow-up on the Reds all at once. We gotta show up too. But they're dug in tight up in here, man. Oh, I'm talking heavy guns, minefields, artillery. But the real deal is here, Fort Jack. Now this is where they control the subs and those nukes they're carrying.
Oh man, we've already been there once. We gotta sail out there again? They've got Isabella. If we move on them now, they'll just waste her. We don't want that. Heck, we control most of New York. Can't we wait till they leave? You know what I'm saying? Like, let them go home, just leave the back door open, let them slip out quietly.
Dog, you're tripping. Look, they're here for good. Did you hear what I'm saying? They're bringing Major back up. They ain't asking for a ride home. They want to smoke us for show. I'm saying, they fixing a wreck on us, kid. They're going to bust out with their big guns. Did your mama drop you on your head or something? Maybe you shouldn't shoot off your mouth until your brain is fully loaded.
All right, I get it. You know, I'm telling you, this is crazy, kid. I'm only doing this for Isabella. Chris, I'm with you. I gotta get in a few shots before the Reds bail out of here. Oh, hey, Junior. You'll need to step aside on this one. It's gonna be a man's job.
Whatever, dog. Yo, Chris, we got some C4 at the base in Yonkers. Way I see it, we got one shot at this. Don't flinch. We gotta step in the ring for a shot at the title.
Punk kids, no respect. Oh, I got brains. I can handle myself.
Somehow I doubt that, Baxton. I seriously do. Well, our weapon stash is close to its former glory, but it actually doesn't matter what you bring for this mission. You will understand pretty soon.
Yo, Governor's Island looks like an impenetrable fortress, but they have a weak spot. The ventilation system. You gotta blow a hole in the giant vent so our boys can roll up inside. That's the only way for them to get onto the island.
You blew it, Baxton. You fucking blew it.
Oh, who put that bozo in charge of the explosives? He lost it. The whole operation is foobar. We may as well pack it up and go home.
Hey, lighten up. Look on the bright side. At least I'm not hurt.
You gotta be resourceful. This mission is too important. It's a long shot, but check out the wrecked helicopter. Maybe there's something we can use.
Stand your ground!
Well, this plan didn't work out at all. Time to save what I can, since I'm apparently the only capable person in the whole rebellion. The first goal is to find a way to take out the machine gun tower, and you really want to be quick about it, because when all the fighters are down, the towers will focus on you and you have pretty much no chance at that point. There is a rocket launcher lying next to some wreckage, and getting there is not easy at all. I had to play this section a couple of times, to be honest. And things are also getting further complicated by us having next to no equipment. Okay, time to make a run for it. Come on, come on, come on! Damn it, I pressed enter one too many times. With the machine gun tower out of the way, I'm free to collect whatever I can find in the area. It won't be much, but it's better than nothing. I managed to pick up a small band of fighters, which will keep me company while making my way onto the island. You'd think that the water would be cold as hell, but nope, Chris is hard as steel. By now you may recognize this place, because it's the same level that we were in when we assassinated General Tatarin. That's why Baxton said that we already were here.
Check our perimeter.
Get moving!
The flag for this sector is easily accessible, but you really want to clear out the sub-objectives before you do it, because otherwise you will screw yourself. To accomplish the sub-objective, I'm going to need some C4, since Baxton dropped our charges into the water.
Regroup!
Everybody!
Let's look for a sewer access point so that I can tell you how this chapter is going to work. First up, since we can't access our old rebel base, we now have this little impromptu sewer bunker thingy on the island. Also, you may notice that there isn't really a stash down here, but we can change this in the future. Okay, here's how this chapter is going to work. There are 5 areas to take care of, and obviously 4J is the last area. For starters, we are going to visit the munitions depot, because I need C4 to let the other fighters onto the island.
Sweet! Here's a chance to get our hands on some major ammo! Find the ammunition depot so we can supply our boys for the final attack on the island. We need that ammo. We can't go in shooting blanks.
As you can see, I am on my own at this point, and it's a good idea to be a bit stealthy about this, because otherwise you will get swarmed. I'm not going to face that heavy trooper with my crappy weapons and without no support. Aside from being a fucking tough fight, it will also draw in other soldiers, and most importantly, it can attract the attention of attack choppers, something that I really don't want to happen. So I'm just going to do it Solid Snake style. Whoops, got turned around here. It's possible to sneak by this group, but it doesn't always work out, so I'm just going to attack them. Also, if you flex your ears, you may be able to hear the chopper sounds in the distance. It's really not a good idea to stay out in the open for too long when you cause a ruckus. Well, with the C4 in my hands, it's time to make my way back. Sadly, I don't have access to my fighter squad from early right now, but it's not really that important. The following events aren't that tough. it's nice of him to make his presence known. And this is something that you will only see in this level, a wounded freedom fighter, very You'll similar to the wounded Soviets.
Give me a report.
Let's go, let's go!
You got it!
Detect and report.
Go, go, go!
Sure thing.
Find the enemy.
Move, move, move!
We'll find them.
And here you can see that the female commandos are quite durable if you do not go for headshots.
Pull out!
You heard me!
Falling in!
Stand your ground!
Team!
I'm holed up here.
The explosion radius is quite large, so I'm going to step away. And here come my friends. Hey guys!
Get back here!
Everybody!
Heck yeah, let's rock and roll!
Yeah. Lock and roll.
This looks a bit like a clown car scene. And it will also take a moment.
Regroup! Come on!
Let's go!
Of course, that ruckus also drew in some Soviets. I quite enjoyed doing that.
Defend here, squad!
I'll be here.
Defend this area! Get moving!
With my fighter support taken care of, it's time to battle my way towards the flag.
Fall back!
Do it!
Lead on!
I love the ragdolls.
Defend! All of you!
Waiting orders, sir!
Defend here, all of you.
For some reason, there's also a wounded civilian here, and there actually are a fair number of them in this last chapter. Don't mind me, I'm just looking for my favorite weapon. And there it is.
Scout ahead.
Move.
The upcoming animations are really clumsy.
Go watch for Ivan.
Come on.
Look at this.
Recon and report.
Team!
Remember how we snuck our way through here? Well, we don't need to do anymore.
Wipe them out!
Go, go, go!
Search over there.
Everybody!
I wasn't sure if he was dead, but it seems so.
Regroup!
Let's go, let's go!
I'm on my way.
I'm actually making a bit of a gamble here, since the area is still well defended, and the Soviets will use choppers to bring in reinforcements. But I'm confident that brute force can make my way through this. And in the back you can see the reinforcements chopper appearing. Let's see if I can beat him to the punch. Right on time. Well, that's it for now. I'm splitting the last chapter into 3 videos, so I'll see you next time with the second part.